yourself some spinach seed. And just before the last snow comes, like the ground is clear, and you hear the storm coming, or rain, just broadcast it out there. And you'll have your first crop. Snow will get on top of it, and it freezes and heaves. It'll plant the seed for you, and you'll have a crop of spinach. But make sure that you get, use organic seed. There's been a lot of trouble with spinach germination in the last 7 to 8 years. And I'm not really surprised about that either. You know, when I was younger, spinach was like a specialty, you know? We didn't have spinach every day. Spinach was kind of expensive. And there were 8 of us. So we ate more Italian bread than pasta than anything else. Eat the bread, eat the bread, my great. Don't drink any water before your meals. Eat the bread. So, but now, it's like everything else, like chicken breast. Having the breast of a chicken was like, you know, we have that every, not frequently. But now it's commonplace because we're growing all this stuff so big and so better. Like if you take a look, the spinach is really inexpensive. And they're in really big bags. I think we have out-hybrided the spinach. I think we have. So if you're disappointed with the spinach, you know, throw kale out. Throw kale out there and see, or mustard, and see which one. Do the mustard.
Doesn't need nitrogen. You know, it needs aeration. It really needs some peat extent.
you put nitrogen. So the balance is off. You know, the balance is off. So it's the refractometer and that Brix number is just going to tell you, you get a low Brix reading, you're going to say, okay, let's say it's a problem. What do you mean? What am I giving? What am I not giving this plant in this particular area? So then you'll delve deeper into broccoli and find out what she really likes, what she wants, what she needs, and you'll add that. Like as an example, tomatoes really like if you add a little bit of bacon soda to the soil. They like it. I don't know why.
It's sweetener,
but they do. You know, so these are all old ways that were correct ways, but we got off the path. We almost jumped off the cliff. But somebody's pulling us back on the little rope so that we could get ourselves out of this situation and just start getting down to fellowship and feeding.
You know, they said, talk about spinach. Spinach is 60% less iron in the new spinach nowadays than it was back in the 50s and 60s. So remember, you used to have spinach for iron, yeah. Not anymore, because it literally is the spinach grown now. All the hybrid spinach is like weak. That is, they're weak plants. They're just for show. They don't have as much iron anymore. You have to eat that much more spinach to get that equivalent iron used to back in the day.
40 portions.
40 portions.
And who likes that spinach that much?
Regular, not the organic ones, but even some of the organic. They may grow organically, but their soil is still not, the soil itself does not have mineral content that it should have in it. So the plant may be grown in an organic method, but the soil of the plant is weak, nutritionally wise.
I was going to talk about apple. I was going to tell you that biodynamics is taught at Michael Fields, which is Wisconsin, but it's a great place. Go online and see what classes they have. Michael Fields.
Michael Fields Institute.
What's that?
It's a regional, similar to Rodale, but it's out of Wisconsin.
Well, it's the biodynamic version of Rodale.
Yes.
And then there's Woods End out in Maine. A lot of work with water. Jennifer Green.
What's that?
That's where it is.